Hello everyone, myself Kashish Talwani and I welcome you all to my channel Simplifying Business Studies. So this is the last session of this chapter, chapter 1 of class 11th, Nature and Purpose of Business. So this session will include the aids to trade or auxiliaries to trade, and also it will include the functions of commerce, or we can say role of commerce. Before I go forward, I would like to request you all to like this video and subscribe to my channel. So we are going to start this session with aids or auxiliaries to trade. So this is another category under commerce. The first one being trade has already been explained in the previous video. If you want the link for it, you can get it in the description box. So what are aids or auxiliaries to trade? So, activities which help in smooth flow of trade are called auxiliaries or aids to trade. Transport, insurance, banking, warehousing, advertising, etc. are regarded as auxiliaries to trade. These activities help in removing various hindrances appearing in the way of trade. So, all these activities, like we have already discussed, transport, insurance, banking, warehousing, advertising. What is the purpose of these activities? The purpose of these activities is to smoothen, is to simplify the process of trade. So all these activities are known as services, and together they constitute as a service industry or tertiary industries. All these services helps in removing different kinds of hindrances, different kinds of barriers in the process of trade. We will definitely do these hindrances in the later part of this chapter. But for now, to understand is the different types of aids in detail. The first one being transportation and communication. Transport refers to the movement of goods from one place to another, and the production of goods takes place at one place, and these goods are demanded at a different place. So this obstacle is removed by transport. For example, tea is produced in Assam and still we are using that tea. We are drinking tea every single morning. So this problem, this hindrance is removed by an aid called transport. Similarly, communication is also a very important service. Without communication, there cannot be business across different states or different countries. So communication helps in exchanging information between producers, consumers and traders. So what are different common communication services? Postal services, telephone services, fax, and nowadays internet. So this is all about transport and communication. Next one is banking and finance. So banks and finance are those institutions which provides credit facility or loan to start or to function different business activities. Bank help the businessmen to overcome the problems of funds, the hindrances of finance or funds. So there are different kinds of facilities we get through banks, which are used regularly in businesses, like issuing of bank draft, discounting of bills, other facilities like overdraft, cash credit limit, arrangement of payments to foreign countries. So all these problems are taken care by this industry called banking and finance. Insurance. So as we have already covered, risk is a very important element, and that is covered by insurance. So there are a lot of insurances available, it can cover our risk due to fire, theft or accident. So insurance companies provide protection to the businesses from the risk of different kinds of accidents which can happen while working. So for this, businessman has to pay a nominal amount called premium, and what they get in exchange of it is the assurance for the compensation if any accidents take place. Next one is warehousing. So usually there is a time gap between the production and the consumption of goods. Goods are usually not consumed immediately after they are produced. For example, wheat and rice, they are produced in a particular season, but these are consumed throughout the year. So it is very important that these things are stored properly so that they can be available throughout the year. So this hindrance, this problem is taken care by warehousing. So warehouses are constructed keeping in mind the nature of goods, and also they facilitate the availability of goods whenever required. Last one is advertising. Practically, it is impossible for manufacturers and traders to contact each and every customer individually. So advertisement fulfills this purpose. Advertisement helps to overcome this problem. How? Advertisement informs the people about different products, the utility of different products, the range of different products, and maybe the uses of different products. So if they like the product, they can approach the people who are trading with similar products, and then they can go and buy the products. So this is how the problem of sending information to the consumers is taken care by this particular aid called advertising. So advertisement directly promotes the sale of goods also. This is how, if you like a product and you have seen that product in an advertisement, you can go and buy that product. So it will definitely helps in selling the product, apart from making the people aware about that product. So it is very good technique for sales promotion, and also it improves the knowledge of customers. The next thing to understand in this session is role or functions of commerce. So we have already covered the meaning of commerce, which means those activities which help directly or indirectly in the distribution of goods to the ultimate consumers. So this distribution process, when it happens, there are a lot of hindrances between. So here comes the role of commerce to remove all these hindrances. What can these hindrances be all about? The people who are producing and using the goods are at different places, or there is a time lag between production of goods and consumption of goods, or there is problem of exchange of goods, or there can be the problem of different kinds of finances for the distribution process. So this is the role of commerce, to remove, to eliminate all these hindrances. What are these hindrances? We will understand one after another. The very first is, it helps in removing the hindrance of person. So a large variety of goods when produced by a group of people, that group of people is called producers. And again, the consumers are the people who consume those goods. So there is no direct communication, no direct contact with these consumers and producers. So trade is that segment of commerce which creates this link where the producer and the consumer meets. So trade is that identity which removes the hindrance of person. Next one is hindrance of place. So goods are produced at one place, whereas the consumers are at different places. Like it may be different places in a country or different places on the globe. So there is a time gap between producers and sorry, not time gap, but place gap between producers and the consumers. So transport is that segment of commerce which helps in removing this hindrance of place. Next one is hindrance of time. So some goods are produced at a particular time in a year, but they are consumed may be throughout the year. Like rice, wheat, they are produced at one time, but they are consumed across the year. Nowadays, we get certain fruits or certain vegetables across the whole year. Like few years back, it was not possible. Like many years back, many decades back. So this is because of the facility called warehousing. It is this segment of commerce which helps in removing the problem of time gap. The goods can be kept safely in the warehouses till they are demanded in the market. And there are various types of warehouses which can be constructed for different types of goods, like cold storage for fruits and vegetables, and inflammable goods in fireproof warehouses, etc. So, hindrance of time is removed by one aid of commerce, which is called warehouse. Another hindrance is hindrance of exchange. So, goods and services are produced by manufacturers and sold to buyers in exchange of money. So, the common money for this exchange can be facilitated by banking and finance. So, this is another aid, another segment of commerce which helps in like removal of this problem called hindrance. For why this is so needed? Because there is a possibility that we are buying something from, we are exporting certain goods, we are into export and import business. So this exchange facility by these institutions like financial institutions and banks is very required to remove this hindrance. So now through these facilities like bank drafts, checks, etc., people can go for the businesses across the globe. Another hindrance is hindrance of risk, which is covered by insurance. So different kinds of risk we have already studied in the same chapter. Different kind of risk are involved in business. Risk of accidents, risk of fire, risk of theft, etc. So all these risks are covered by an entity called insurance, which is another aid of commerce through which business is made simple and safe. Last under the category is hindrance of knowledge. Generally, the consumers and the buyers are unaware about the new products produced by different manufacturers. And definitely, there is no direct communication, no direct contact between the manufacturer and the consumer. So, through advertising, through this segment of commerce, people get to know about the products and the services which are available by certain people across the world, so that they can be benefited by this kind of information and they can choose the right product. So advertisement is one branch of commerce which helps in removing the hindrance of knowledge by spreading awareness about the new products and their utility. So for example, let's take just one more example. We get to know about better gadgets in the market, better things in the market, like what we use on daily basis. So this helps us get the best product and maybe at the best price. So these are all the hindrances which are removed by different aids of commerce. Children, we are done with the session, done with the chapter also. So my next videos will contain certain assignments which will help you to understand what kind of questions you may face, you may attempt in your examinations. And also there will be a variety of questions in those assignments. Like we can include OTQs, objective type questions of different types, one marker questions, and also case studies. So please continue watching these videos, and also do not forget to like and subscribe. I hope my content has been useful and productive to all of you, and I will keep on working like this for your benefit. Thank you so much all for watching.